ग्रेड 9 इंग्लिश प्यूपल बुक एवरीबॉडी इज गुड एट समथिंग द एक्टिविटी 1 एक्टिविटी 1 इज A script to act out. I will just read. Malik and Pubudu are talking about a TV program. Hello, Pubudu. Did you watch the contest of Children Can Sing on TV yesterday? Yes, I did. You know, all my family are music lovers, so we watched it all together. There was quite a large audience at the show, wasn't there? Yes, the hall was full. And what about the boy who came first? He had a great voice. He sure did. The audience were already clapping their hands when his name was announced. Yes. They must have guessed all along that he was going to be the winner. What about the orchestra? It was quite big. There were nearly 30 members in it. Yes, the orchestra were all talented. They did a wonderful job. Yes, you took the words right out of my mouth. Okay, children, did you understand the scenario here?
Yes, teacher.
We have some questions. Now I'm going to see those questions in the book because we have answers in my slide. Okay. Question number 1. What is the TV program mentioned in the dialogue? What is the name of the TV program put there? Can you see on the screen?
Children Can Sing.
Very good. Children Can Sing. Now when you're writing the answers, you have to make sure C capital, S capital Y. This is the name of a show. TV show. It's a proper noun. Question number 2. Did Pubudu watch it alone?
No, he isn't. He watched it with his family.
Very good. No, he didn't. Now your question starts with did. No, he didn't. He watched with his family. Very good. Number 3. Who had a great voice?
The boy who came first.
Very good. Number 4. How many members did the orchestra consist of? The orchestra consisted of
30 members.
Yes, the orchestra consisted of nearly 30 members in it. Okay. Number 5. Before that, we will see the answers for that one. Okay, let's write these ones quickly. Okay, children, have you finished?
Yes, Tish, I did.
Okay. How about both of you? Where is my screen? Put it in the screen. Can you still see the answers?
No, teacher.
What can you see? I can't find my...
Only two questions are there. Now okay. Can see, teacher.
Okay, right. Okay. Now we will go to the next one. You took the words right out of my mouth. What does this mean? Number A, I didn't understand what you said. B, I was going to say the same thing. C, I don't agree with you. What do you think? You took the
I was going to say the same thing.
Very good. Yes. Now number five. You have two question five. Find words in the conversation which mean much the same as the following. Said officially or in public. What do you think?
Announce.
Very good. How about almost?
Nearly.
Very good. A group of listeners or spectators?
Audience.
Very good. Very good. Let's do. Okay, let's move on. Now children, we are going to learn a lesson here about collective nouns. Right? I will just read. When we use a collective noun, we can use either a singular or a plural verb. The choice depends on whether we see the group as a whole or as a number of individual members. We use a singular verb if the group acts as a single unit, and a plural verb when the members of the group act as a number of individuals. Now I will just teach you a little bit about the collective nouns. Now collective nouns can be groups of people, can be groups of animals, or can be groups of things. Right, all these are called collective nouns. I remember showing you pictures of collective nouns in the class. I hope you remember. Right, now here, groups of people. Right, collective nouns for people, a group of people. A group of people in a house is called a family. Like that, you can call a team, a community, a choir, a band, an orchestra, an audience, a crew, a club, a committee, a company, a gang, the government, the army. Now, here people gather together for different purposes. If a group of people gather with their musical instruments to play, so they are called an orchestra or a band, right? If a group of people get together to do business and to have some profit, now they are called a company, right? So things like that. Now let's move on to collective nouns that can be used again for groups of people. A crowd of shoppers, a company of actors. When a lot of actors get together, you call them a company of actors. A class of school children, a gang of thieves, a panel of judges, a platoon of soldiers. Right, now animals also get in groups, right? So we use special collective nouns for animals also. A herd of cattle, a flock of birds, a drove of sheep, a gaggle of geese, a pack of wolves, a pride of lions, a pod of dolphins, a school of fish, a litter of puppies, a troop of monkeys, a brood of chickens, and a swarm of bees. Now, when you have a lot of wolves together, you call them a pack, right? There's a pack of wolves there, like that. When you have certain things grouped, you can use collective nouns for those as well. For example, a bunch of bananas, a cluster of grapes, a bunch of flowers, a bouquet of flowers, a range of mountains, a fleet of ships, a fleet of vehicles, a deck of cards, a flight of steps, a suite of rooms, a suite of furniture, a set of tools, a string of beads, a grove of trees, right? When you have a lot of flowers bound together, you can call it a bunch of flowers or bouquet of flowers, like that. Now we are going to see the verb agreement when it comes to collective nouns. That means, how do you use verbs when collective nouns are there? Now imagine, if the group we are talking about is acting as a single unit, then we use a singular verb, right? For example, here, I hope you can see the mouse pointer. The crowd was orderly. That means we consider people in the crowd all to be orderly, right? Because we consider this one to be a single unit here. Then you use a singular verb. Was is a singular verb. Now, on the other hand, if the members of this crowd, if the people in this crowd were acting as individuals, they were doing different things, or they were doing things as individuals, then we use a plural verb, because we are referring to so many people within a group. For example, the crowd were clapping, yelling, and cheering. See, people were clapping in the group and they were yelling and they were cheering. So in this case, we do not consider this crowd as a single unit. Instead, we use a plural verb here. Instead, we consider them as acting as individuals. Right. There is a note here. Always use a plural verb with the collective nouns, people and the police. For example, when you use the word people, it is always plural. You never say people in my town is rich. You don't say that. Okay, you have to use people in my town are rich. Right? For example, those people live in Asia, not lives. It's plural verb here. The police, whenever you say the police, it's always considered to be a plural collective noun. So the police have caught, not has caught. It's plural. Do you understand, both of you?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, right. I will show you some more examples. When to use a singular verb. Now, I already told you, when all the members of a collective noun are performing an action as a singular unit, as one unit, then we use a singular verb. For example, the chamber orchestra often plays at the arts center. Now, this orchestra as a whole, as a unit, we look at them. They always, all the members of the orchestra often play at the arts center. Now, you consider this orchestra to be one piece. The cast is celebrating the success of the play with a party after the performance. Now, they are doing this as one unit. We look at this cast as one unit here. A wolf pack, you can say a pack of wolves, hunts as a group, right? This pack hunts as a group. We look at the wolves in that as one pack, not as individual wolf. The fleet, was anchored in the channel. Now here the fleet is a fleet of ships, right? So we don't look at them as individual ships, right? Ship number one anchored, ship number two anchored, ship number three anchored. No, we all the ships as to be one fleet, right? Then you have to use the singular verb over here. Let's see when to use a plural verb. When the members of a collective noun are performing an action as individuals. Now they are performing one action as individuals, then use a plural verb. Now let's see. Okay, there's something else. In this case, all or some members of the group are doing something independently of the other members. The group is not acting together as a unit. Now, the orchestra are tuning their instruments. Now, children, you know, in an orchestra, you have many people playing different instruments. Not that everyone is playing violins, right? You have one person playing a violin, another person playing a cello, another person playing a piano, like that. So let's say we have a violinist, a cellist, and a guitarist, right? These people are tuning their instruments. Now one person is tuning a violin, one person is tuning a cello, the other person is tuning a guitar. So they are all doing tuning, I know, but they are doing it as individual units. All of these three people do not come and tune a violin together. No. I hope you understand. That's why we use are here. There are three people tuning three different instruments in the orchestra. Again, the cast has been practicing their lines. Now, if you take a play, imagine there are three actors here. The cast means three actors. One is Cinderella, the other one is the stepmother, the other one is the prince, let's say. Are they all practicing Cinderella's lines? No, they are practicing individually. One is practicing Cinderella, the other one is practicing stepmother, and the other one is practicing the prince's lines. Even though they are doing the same thing, they are doing that particular thing independently, right? The flock, this flock can be a flock of sheep, were running off in every direction. One sheep may be running to the north and the other one is to the south. We don't know. They are all running, but they are doing the particular action, running independently. The staff disagree on the proposal. Right? In many cases, it may sound more natural to make the subject plural in form by adding a verb, word-like members. Now, for example, rather than saying the orchestra are tuning their instruments, you can say, to make it more natural, the members of the orchestra are tuning their instruments, like that. The cast members have been practicing their lines. The staff members disagree on the proposal. Now all these members disagree on the proposal on individual basis, like independently. Right. Now when you say the staff disagree on the proposal, there can be, now imagine this is a staff of 100 people. There can be one or two people who necessarily don't disagree, right? I will show you another example. The soccer team marches in the parade. Now, when you talk about the marching, you consider the soccer team to be one unit, right? You talk about the team as one unit. But when you say the soccer team have many different skills, that means in the soccer team, let's say there are three players. One player is excellent at, let's say, kicking. The other person is excellent at goalkeeping, like that. So you are talking about the individuals in the team on an individual basis. So that's why this is plural. Again, there's another example. The jury has awarded the custody to grandmother. This is a collective decision taken by the jury. All of them as a single unit agree on this. So you use has. But when you say, sorry, the jury members have been arguing for 5 days, so that means it is something done by the members individually, independently, right? So the focus is more on each member, not the jury as a team. So that is why it's plural here. Okay, we have an activity here. Let's see if you can tell me the correct answers. The answers are crew, team, there, has, are. A cricket
team.
Very good. Team consists of 11 players. The medical team. Very good. Are discussing how they can tackle the dengue problem. Number 3. About then? What can come here?
There.
There was, very good. There was a TV crew at the ceremony. It should be CR here. Number 4. The ship's
crew
were all saved by the Navy. They were the crew. Why did they use a plural here? Because each member of the crew was saved individually. The band
has
only one guitarist. Now you are talking about the band as a single unit. Very good. Now this T is capital. I hope you remember to do that. Moving on. This one. Their family
is
smaller than ours. Now you are talking about the family as a unit. The crowd now they were sorry I think I said the answer what is the answer now these people were cheering at the top of their voices individually, right? The focus is more on the people in the crowd rather than the crowd as a single unit.
So the crowd were?
Very good. The crowd were. Next one. There, a small crowd. This is a singular noun. So what should come here?
Is.
There is a small crowd outside the gate. Very good. All her family. Now this is this.
Are.
Very good. All her family members. All her family are vegetarians. The cricket team. Now they have individually, very good, they have individually finished their warm-up exercises, right? Okay, it's have. Please check the answers. Okay, now Before we move on to the other one, please take your workbook now.